Welcome to the tutorial on 3:8 decoder using IC74138 and BCD decoder using IC74LS42. In this particular tutorial, we focus on implementing a 3:8 decoder using the IC74138. The IC74138 consists of three active high inputs which are labeled as ABC and eight active low output lines which are labeled as Y, and along with this we have three enable pins, and these three enable pins are G1, G2A and G2B. So the device will be functional as a decoder only when G1 is equal to logic 1 and G2A and G2B is at logic 0. Under all other conditions, the outputs will be high. So this you can observe clearly in the truth table that is shown. When G1 is equal to logic 1, you can see that the outputs are obtained to be active low, that is logic 0. For all other cases, when G1 is 0 or G2A or G2B is equal to logic 1, the output will be all 1s. And clearly we can see that the IC74138 is a 16 pin IC with 8th pin being the ground and 16th pin connected to the VCC. For the realization of the decoder IC74138, when we represent the minterms and combine them, we are going to use a NAND gate. And using the NAND gate, we can represent the minterms. Specifically, the numericals based on the IC74138, instead of using the NAND gate representation in this manner, we represent by bubbling the inputs and using a OR gate. So this representation is equivalent to that of a NAND gate representation. So in all the numericals that we solve, we can see that the NAND gate representation is shown in this manner. To implement the given function using the IC74138, so what we are going to do is we are going to make use of, so first I'm going to mark the input variables ABC corresponding to the function which are indicated as lowercase marked in green, and then I know that for the circuit to be functional, I need to give G1 to the VCC and G2A and G2B has to be grounded. Then looking at the minterms, I am going to use NAND gate and obtain the output. So as a second question, I have that I need to implement the function f of x, y, z for the max terms. In the case of max terms, what we are going to do is we are going to ground G2A and G2B in a similar manner like the previous case. G1 is connected to the VCC and we have ABC considered as the input variables X, Y, Z, and then we are going to look at the decimal notations corresponding to the max terms, that is 1, 2, 4 and 6, and connect them using the AND gate. In the third question, we have the implementation of the functional pairs using the IC74138. So the functional pairs are given to be 0, 1, 5, 6 and 7 in terms of min terms, and the second function is given to be 1, 2, 3, 6 and 7. So all of these have the same variable, input variables ABC. So I will require to mark the input variables a, b, c in the lower case and connect G1 to VCC, G2 A and G2 B to ground, and for the function F1 and function F2 corresponding to the decimal notations that I mentioned, I will connect them using the NAND gate. Next question I have that I need to implement using the IC74138, the functions that are specified using the minterms 0 to 4. That is corresponding to function F1, and the function F2 is given as summation 1, 2, 4, 5 and 7. In this particular case, the implementation can be done in two ways. Either you can implement using the NAND gate or you can implement using the AND gates. That is, I can implement the minterms or in terms of max terms. Both of these implementations using the NAND gate or the AND gate, both are correct, but you need to take care that you are representing either in minterms or in terms of max terms. So from this numerical, we have understood that if you are representing the IC74138 using the minterms, we need to make use of NAND gate. And if you are representing in terms of the max terms, we need to make use of the AND gates. And in general, we make an observation when we are representing the minterms, that is summation m, if it is a active high output, we use the OR gate. If it is a active low output, we use the NAND gate. In the case of the max terms, if it is a active high output, we use the NOR gate, and if it is a active low output, we use the AND gate. So far we have understood that the IC74138 is a 3:8 decoder IC, and if we want to design it for a 4:16, then what we need to do is we need to make use of two ICs of 74138, and we are going to place these ICs with the enable pin G1 connected to the supply for the first case and G1 connected to G2A, which will be given to the MSB bit of the input. So let me consider ABCD to be the inputs of the decoder, and I will be having 16 output lines. So I will be connecting the ABC pins of the 74138 IC to the LSB bits, that is B, C, D respectively, and A I'm going to connect it to G2A of the first IC and G1 of the second IC, whereas enable equal to 0 will be connected to G2B of the first IC and G2A of the second IC. The G2B of the second IC will be grounded and G1 of the first IC will be connected to VCC. In this particular case, I will consider the outputs to be Z in general, so that I can denote that there are 16 outputs ranging from Z0 to Z15. The reason for this way of implementation is because in general what we do is we always connect G1 to the supply, that is VCC, and G2A and G2B will be connected to ground to function it as a decoder. In this particular case, for the first IC on the top, G1 is connected to VCC as usual, whereas G2A is connected to A, which is equal to 1, and this 1 will be given to G2A with the bubbling. So it becomes A to be equal to 0 for the first case, whereas for the lower IC, A is directly connected to G1, so that means it will be equal to logic 1, equivalent to connecting it to the VCC. Whereas if you look at G2A, that is connected to the enable input of the first IC, which is equal to 0. So it is equivalent to saying that G2A and G2B of the second IC are grounded and G1 is connected to VCC. From what we have understood, let us implement two functions, F1 and F2, using IC74138 decoder. So we know the connections as to how we have to connect the different enable pins. So I'm considering the LSP variables, that is B, C, D, connected to the input pins, and I'm going to consider the MSB variable A, indicated with small letter A, to be connected to G2A of the first IC and then connected to G1 of the second IC. Now, in the question, they have given the functions in terms of minterms, so I have to represent the outputs by combining the various minterms that are specified using the NAND gate. So I can form the function F1 using the NOR gate, which has the decimal notation 0, 4, 8, 10, 14 and 15, and the function F2 with the decimal notations 3, 7, 9 and 13. For ease, what I'm going to do is I will be marking the decimal notations onto the IC outputs so that there is no confusion with the numbering. Next, we have the implementation of 5:32 decoder using 3:8 decoder IC 74138 and a 2:4 decoder. As we discussed earlier, using decoders, it is possible for us to design larger decoders. So same thing has been done here. We are using 4:74138 ICs. We are doing the connections for the supply, that is G1 of all the 74138 ICs is connected to VCC, and we are going to ground the G2B pin, that is the enable pin. And for the 2:1 decoder, we are going to use the enable pin and the MSB bits A and B will be connected to the 2:4 decoder, whereas the LSB bits C, D and E will be connected to the IC74138 of all of them. From the outputs obtained from the 2:4 decoder, that will be A bar B bar, A bar B, A B bar and AB corresponding to 00011011, we will be giving this output to each of the G2A of the 74138 IC. So from there we can obtain the outputs ranging from 0 to 7 in decimal for the first IC. From the second IC, we can obtain the outputs from 8 to 15. From the third IC, we can obtain outputs from 16 to 23. And from the fourth IC, we can obtain outputs from 24 to 31. Hence, it is possible for us to design a larger decoder using many smaller decoders. Next in line we have the BCD decoders. The BCD decoders have 4 inputs and 10 outputs. The 4-bit BCD inputs are decoded to one of the 10 outputs. And in this case, we make use of the IC74LS42, which is a BCD to decimal decoder MSI integrated circuit. And this produces an active low output. So with the truth table and the logic circuit, we will see how we obtain or realize or simplify the expressions and obtain the output for different cases. The decimal output is denoted as Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5, Y6, Y7, Y8 and Y9, and you can see that corresponding to the BCD input, the output obtained is active low or logic 0. So for the implementation of the logic circuit, we make use of the NOT gate and the NAND gate, and the circuit diagram is shown for various outputs.